Hey, I'm Scientifico, and today we're taking a look at Fragments of Him. It's an indie game that was just released. Okay, let's take a look at it. And this is weird because it brings me to another title screen. Start the game. You can also move forward by holding down the left mouse button. Okay. Oh, hey, cool. Oh wow, I can't. I just fucking click and there you go. Alright, what do you got for me? What is this? What was that? Oh. Okay, I guess that's him. Or a fragment of him, at least. Okay, so he took the keys, he's going out the door. He's probably gonna go party. Snazzy duds. Let me go through the door here. I've gotta follow this guy. Okay, another loading screen. Interesting choice. Oh, cool. Bye, Harry. See you tonight. Say nothing. Wait a minute. Who am I saying this to? Say nothing. No. Bye, Harry. See you tonight. Or I love you. Have a good day. I don't know who I'm saying this to. Okay, I'll do this one.
I love you. Have a good day.
Okay, cool. Thanks. You too, buddy.
This life's been kind to me, and I've got to change. To stop taking it for granted.
How did you close the door like that? That was impressive. It's like your hands were sticky and just... Alright, whatever. I'm not going to read too much into it. This is interesting. What the fuck? Oceans and... Okay, can't read any of that. Cool. What is that? What's that van doing out there? He's just hanging out. He's watching me. Alright, he's
probably looking at... I forget sometimes how beautiful this city is.
You are super British. Yeah, so, okay, you just do that. Fucking, where the hell does that wire do? Like, what does that do? Alright, just continue on. Just quick walk. Can I look in here? Apps, what? Oh, right click backs me up. Alright, that was a little weird. That doesn't do anything. Super Walking Simulator 2000. Oh, hey, look at this. Who's this? Wait, I want to see... What kind of fucking weird... Oh, here we go. Oh, that's interesting. Can I take that or go down the stairs? I guess we'll go down the stairs.
The exercise is good for me.
Goddamn right. You fucking go down that stairs there.
Sure, I go to the gym. But will that see me through?
No, seriously, dude. You're just walking down a flight of stairs. This is really not exercise at all. Like, it's one thing.
Little bits of exercise are better than an occasional hour?
Actually, no. That's not true at all. You need both.
I should feel closer to Harry, but the tech is like a tide slowly pulling at us.
What do you mean, the tech? What tech? Is he, like, augmented? Is this, like, one of those human revolution things?
No more. I'll stop that drift.
What do you mean? What is going on here, buddy? Who is Harry? I fucking thought I had it and then it's gone.
I'm going to change things.
Okay, you do that. You go change things and I'll do my thing and climb in the car with you. So you don't want to, like, you know, run there for extra exercise. You can change the camera sensitivity in the options menu. Well, that's good to know. I'm glad I found that.
I don't want to lose what we've got to by not paying attention to it.
Okay, cool. Just you fucking do that. I just remembered. I'm in, like, the UK and the drive on the right side. Okay, just fucking fix that mirror. Turn on the tunes. Fucking just recline your seat, I guess. Just Why is your seat different? Don't you drive this thing, like, every day? Alright, fucking seatbelt.
Some routine is good. Sure.
Yeah, sure, alright, that's fine. Can we drive now?
Other routines are just how we fill our days.
Wait, the ignition's on the left-hand side too? Are you fucking serious? I have no idea what your name is. I'm gonna name you Joe. You look like a Joe. Alright, Joe, let's fucking rock and roll. There we go. I am driving with a mannequin right now. This is the coolest. By the way, how do you get your complexion so ceramic? It's amazing. I feel like a fucking dog right now. I feel like I'm just gonna fucking stick my head out the window. By the way, you are a pretentious asshole for listening to Classic. Like, I know there's probably, like, a lot of people that love listening to Classic to unwind and shit. And driving is probably one of those things that you enjoy. But you don't. I know you. You're that type of dude that is like, I'm gonna be super pretentious because I can. You probably own a tweed jacket. Just like Alan Wake.
I should have paid more attention to the small stuff. Not locked on to avoiding everything that matters.
I still have no idea what you're talking about. Are you talking about a relationship? Like, with a lover or friends? I don't know, and that is a boxy Jeep. Holy shit. Wait a minute. Why are we... Oh, yeah. Okay.
Living carefree has been good, but it's not going anywhere.
Well, just carefree. You need plans, dude. You've gotta have plans. You can't live carefree. If you live carefree, then you fucking, like,
piss away a lot of time. It's time to take control.
Yeah, you stop interrupting me. I'm trying to talk to myself here. Because apparently I'm hovering in the seat. Holy shit! Joe, do you see this? They're building something with that thing there. By the way, has anyone ever told you that your car's, like, UI or whatever you want to call it, is, like, super blurry?
I always smile when I really see that place. Maybe we'll go there tonight.
Dude, pay attention! Holy shit! What the... Dude, don't fucking do like... Oh, I love this place. Holy fuck, I'm driving. Okay. No, just calm down. He's fucking... We'll figure that shit out. God damn it. You are the worst fucking British driver ever. Watch this, dude. Please, you freaking... Holy shit, your head. Oh, okay. It's just... Really weirdly placed headphones. Why are your headphones so high? Please, just... Alright, I'll
we'll
see you.
Maybe we'll feed the ducks this weekend. I love the way they walk.
They're fucking ducks, dude. How can you... Why are you talking to yourself? Like, I'm not here. Like, I'm a ghost of future past or something.
He's got to know how I feel about him. I love him so much.
Oh, okay, so... what was his name? Harry? Harry's probably... Holy shit! Okay, so apparently fucking, like, clicking on people kills them. It's like a death note, but with the mouse. Oh, hey, there I am. Or there's that dude, and there's this guy. Let me get that for you guys. Just don't feel fucking weirded out. I'm just watching you sleep. I'll turn off your alarm for you.
Every day that alarm goes off. I should change the tone on it. Though, Harry always sleeps through it, so that's something.
Okay, here, take a drink of this fucking water.
This isn't what I imagined or wanted. Drifting through one day after another. Together, but not aware. Something like that.
Are you a fucking X-Men? Because you just... You didn't even come close to picking that up. You were like here, and you're like, oh, by the way, I want to take a drink. And it was like, whom. That was fucking cool. Good job, buddy. Hey, Harry, by the way, listen, I don't want to be a dick, but your fucking... Your boyfriend or husband or whatever you want to call him. Like, he is... He's a fucking mutant, dude. Like, he's super fucking mutiny. What is this?
Why have I just passed by this for so long? It's beautiful.
It's a painting. It is beautiful, but you're being pretentious again. Like, just... Hey, what is this? Love not consumed in passion's heart, but golden flame and steadfast. Supped? sweet. Okay, there we go. Can I look out the window? Can I just, like, click on Harry and just stare at him for, like, 30 minutes? You just see a clock go by. Just staring. Closer. Closer. And then he wakes up and you're like, oh, sorry, Harry. It's not a big deal. Just put on your socks now, dude. Okay, come on. I knew this was your sock drawer. You know how I knew that? Because every drawer on the fucking left, for some goddamn reason, is a sock drawer. Here, open this bad boy up. Look at those fucking shirts.
I think I'll wear this one. It's Harry's favorite t-shirt on me.
Okay, we get it. You love Harry. That's fine. Even if it was a girl, you know, you don't have to fucking, like, wear everything. Let's see. This is fucking... Oh, yeah, books. I didn't even see the glowing blue books here.
I reread the same books time and again. It's comforting, I guess.
Or it may be a mental disorder. You may want to get that checked out, seriously. Let's see what kind of books you got. Frankenstein. Okay. The Night Before Christmas. Why do you have The Night Before Christmas? You just keep reading around. Is that something you do? I can't read that one. Shakespeare's sonnets, okay? So you... Dude, you are super hipster! Holy fuck! Andrew. Dracula. The Dice Man. Charlotte's Web. Treasure Island. Oh man, Treasure Island was my grandfather's favorite book. I remember that one. Oh, God bless you, Grandpa. Alright, the Hogfather. Alright, we're out of here. This is too fucking pretentious
daily
for me.
Things. They're good. But weigh us down, too.
It's a jacket.
I've got to a good place in life, but I feel like I'm not taking it further.
Then just get a different jacket. It's not a big deal. That was just... if you need a jacket, I recommend tweed. One with little patches on the elbows to complete the, like, jackassery
look.
Even
here, I get into patterns. Bathroom first, then kitchen for breakfast.
Well,
maybe
yeah,
I should change
dude.
That.
Why? You fucking do not understand. Life is about, like, slight patterns. Do you know how fucking crazy you would be if you didn't have little patterns? Like, here's a pattern. All right? The three S's. You shit, shower, and shave. All right? If you fuck that up, then guess what? You fucked everything up, dude. And your whole day goes totally backwards.
Every change helps.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I changed
tea.
That. Oh, I was supposed to go in the bathroom first. Well, you know, see, this is what happens. You do this out of order and then you get hit by a car. Let that be a lesson to all people.
A man takes the lead, Grandma would tell me. I guess I need to step up to the line. I've got a great thing here.
I don't have anything smart-assery to say about that one. It's there. I know it's there. Holy shit, dude.
She's a good woman at heart. Old-fashioned, but still. She's right. A man steps up to challenges. I'll ask Harry to marry me. Husband and husband for the rest of our lives.
I get it. You're gay. That's okay. Husband and husband was a little over-pushing it, dude.
I think maybe Grandma would be okay with it these days. Then again, maybe she wouldn't.
Wait, is that Grandma's fucking ashes? Do you have Grandma's ashes in the fucking kitchen? What is wrong with you, Joe? What is fucking wrong with you right now?
Naturally, as Will's grandmother, I visited Will in hospital on the first day that he was born. James, Will's father, handed him to me. Wrapped in a little blue blanket. I'll never forget that moment. He was such
Grandma,
a handsome baby. James ran three London pubs in the 1980s. Of that punk sort. He looked awful with that leather jacket and those sort of things. That's not the sort of thing for children. So I would babysit as often as possible to make sure he had someone normal in his life.
Grandma, you're listening to, like, fucking grunge punk rock or whatever. Like, turn this shit off, okay? Just water the plant, Grandma. Do something else.
I always thought Step up to the channel. Play outside more. He preferred making up stories, even back then.
Yeah, because fuck him for being creative. What is this?
Sharon was always reading. She taught art history. Never really made much money.
Jesus, Grandma, you're like just a fucking asshole. You know that? You're like the most bitter grandma I've ever met.
Will's birth wasn't very easy.
Fuck, dude. Can you have anything positive to say, Grandma?
He's gonna have brothers or sisters after that.
Holy shit, Grandma. Like, oh, this little shit. He was a fucking terrible bastard. He should have been a boy. Like, fuck. Calm down, Grandma. Calm down. By the way, you don't have eyes. That's creepy as shit. What is this?
Sharon, Will's mother, broke up with James for 3 years at one point and took Will away to America, where she comes from. They had met through James's work. No wonder, really.
Okay.
James and Sharon both loved so-called music, and there was always something playing around Will. I thought it was an awful racket, personally. But there's no accounting for tastes. I turned it off when I was babysitting.
I wish I knew that was... You know what, Grandma? Grandpa was probably cooler. All right, I'm just throwing it out there. Are you fucking pretentious too? The rats. Oh, I thought that said the dog. I'm like, it's a fucking whole book here. Like, this is about the spirit... Oh my God. It is no joke. 2:15 in the fucking morning. Who is texting me right now at 2:15 in the morning?
James had horror books in the house, and I'm so glad they were kept on a high shelf away from Will. Terrible things. I just don't understand what pleasure there is in that kind of story.
Oh,
I
my
loved
God.
Him. I always just wanted him to have the
Grandma,
best
Grandma, you're going to make me stick my dick in a light socket to fucking end this, okay?
I suppose I sound awful, saying his parents were doing everything wrong.
Jesus Christ, kid, I feel so bad for you. Like, you are the most negative fucking person on the planet. What are you gonna say about this? I bet you, right fucking now, something about being this is a fucking mess or you leave shit undone. And if I'm right, if I'm fucking right, I'm gonna say nothing but nada.
I remember that night because Will had been unusually quiet all evening.
Well, fuck me, that's an awkward silence. Oh, I'm supposed to be doing something.
He told me that he'd been in a fight. Another boy had been calling a girl names because she had dark skin.
Good, I hope you kicked his fucking ass.
Will was punched in the stomach when he tried to get the boy to stop.
Okay, well, at least you stuck to your, you know, your conscience. I am proud of you, boy.
I asked
proud of you,
him
whatever
if he
your name
cried.
Is.
And he said yes.
Well, sometimes that, you know, that happens. You're still a baby. I don't know, you're like, what, fucking 5 or 7 or something?
I told him that big boys don't cry. I remember him asking me then, what do big boys do when they're sad?
They bottle it upside, Johnny. They bottle upside until we have to go through incredibly difficult and painful, like, therapy sessions. No, I'm just fucking, dude. Just, you know, if you feel like crying, cry. Just fucking, I don't give a shit. You're 7! Grandma's fucking nuts!
When he was grown up, I told him he would be a good man. He would be able to stand up to others.
You will be emotionally numb by then. Holy shit, how many pieces are left on this thing?
He had done the right thing, I told him. Even though it hurt him that time.
This story's fucking awful. Like, seriously? Dude, Johnny, I'm gonna have to buy you more of these things so you can make, like, some crazy cool... Whoa. Why is this... Wait, oh, that's a wall. Okay.
Looking back, I don't think he seemed very comforted.
Really, Grandma? I have no idea why. Jesus. All right, let's pick this thing up.
Will tripped over his toy van when he was going to bed.
Nice. Smooth move, dude. Walk it off. You're fine. By the way, that was really fucking stupid. Alright, come on.
I remember carrying him. He was trying so hard not to cry.
What, were you carrying him by the fucking neck? Because apparently you are just absolutely fucking insane. You are an emotionless robot.
Here, just open the door. He was so small in my arms. I've never forgotten that feeling.
As you phase through the fucking door. Oh my god, this is a good game. I know this is trying to be emotional, but it's just not working right now. There's too much shit to go on. No, fucking cool room, though, dude.
I have so many little memories making up our lives together.
Oh my god, Grandma.
What sticks with you, though?
It was all the times I told him not to be a little pussy, and then I mocked him for when he cried. Oh, haunted house. You know, I don't know. Something. Mysterious World, Charlotte's Web, The Secret Seven, Roald Dahl, Book of Ghost Stories, Night Before Christmas. Again, this family fucking loves The Night Before Christmas. The Sinister Signpost. I am interested in what a signpost can be sinister about. Secret Seven Win Through. Fuck if I know what that's about. Oxford, okay, good. Yeah, good. I'm glad you've got light reading him like the Oxford Dictionary.
I took him to bed to read him a story.
Yeah, but just don't fucking lie. You just plopped him on the bed and then you just walked out. Like the unfeeling robot you are. Oh my god, what is that? This does not fit the fucking bedroom right now. And there's this thing here and what is this? U.S. Born Guide to Computers. Cool.
Sharon kept on buying him books of ghost stories. He always wanted me to read him those, but he never slept properly after, I think.
You know, this is probably why I am confused. You tell him to, like, man up, right? And then you're like, hey, don't read this shit, it'll fucking scare you. Like, Grandma, pick a fucking side here. We're gonna read this shit.
I made sure he could see me looking carefully.
Grandma, do you normally press your forehead against the wall? Why did you make sure he saw you doing that? Did you phase behind the fucking bookshelf? Grandma, it's gotta be at least like 6:30. Holy shit, kid. I am so fucking sorry. And that is a massive plug for this light bulb.
He would never settle properly until I had checked the room for ghosts.
Fucking Grandma, you're killing me. Please stop. Look at how many foot. It's brighter than the fucking sun in here, Johnny. Look at this. You've got four lamps. This is at least 600,000 lumens, judging by this fucking plug. Look at this fucking book, too. Jesus Christ. Now Grandma's gonna laugh at your bitch ass. Just pick up the book.
I remember that night because I promised him then that I would always be there for him, to protect him, regardless of anything. He probably thought I meant about ghosts, but I meant it for everything. It's not the kind of promise you forget.
Yeah, okay, so what in the fuck is this massive monster about? Read that. I want to know what it is. Holy shit, you actually picked up the item!
I was reading Grimm's fairy tales to him. More than the new versions that they kept on coming out with back then.
What?
That night was a strange story called The Ungrateful Son.
This should be good.
It went something like this.
You're kidding me. Am I being transported into the bookworm?
A man and his wife were eating a roast chicken for dinner.
Okay.
When the man saw his father, who was very old, walking up the road towards them, the man didn't want to share, and so he hid the chicken out of sight. The man's father arrived, bid them good day, and continued on his way.
It wouldn't be so awkward if Dad didn't come by like every Tuesday night to fucking eat my food.
The man was very happy, and so told his wife to put the chicken on the table again.
Fuck! Dude, you got caught. Like, seriously, did you think putting the chicken under the fucking table?
But the chicken had transformed into a giant toad, which leapt onto the face of the man.
Wow, how terrifying.
The toad would never leave, and when his wife wanted to help, she was so afraid of it that she dared not go near. The man had to feed the toad every day from then on, or it would bite his face, and he never rested for the remainder of his life.
For what? All he did was not give his fucking dad a chicken. Like, fucking dad. His dad is a sorcerer.
It was a very strange story.
Yeah, no shit. Alright, apparently frog. Like, even if a frog were to bite you, would it really be that bad? And how weak of a man are you that you can't tear this toad
off
you?
Will was asleep before I finished it, which was probably a good thing.
Yeah, I'm sure it was. Jesus, every time they do that, I think, like, we're in the fucking Animus. Turn that bad boy off. Wow. Holy shit. What did that turn off? Like, seriously, that didn't do a goddamn thing. Oh, here we go. Turn that off. Turn this one off.
I felt strange after reading it. I wondered about whether I really could keep him safe.
Yeah, I'm sure you can, dude. Are you serious right now? Kid. God, okay, whatever. Fucking, it's your electricity bill.
I knew I would do my best to help him find his place in the world. Any other grandmother would try to do the same.
Grandma, stop fucking peeping on him. Come on, get out of here.
I still see him sleeping there now. Like it was only yesterday.
That is so fucking weird, Grandma. Get out of here. I'll just watch him sleep. Oh, I can pause the game by pressing escape. Excellent.
I never thought it would be easy. But I had raised James, so I thought I would be ready for anything from my grandson Will. The world changes so quickly.
Oh man, this is gonna be tough. Cause, dude, I don't know how much I can take of Grandma right now. Holy shit, I'm gonna sneeze. Yeah, god damn. Okay, that was... Yep, sorry. I'm just gonna click all these
guys. I remember
guys.
The family visiting me when Will was a teenager.
Are we gonna put on punk rock right now?
Did you ever hear the song, Here in My Heart? That was playing when Robert first kissed me. Al Martino had a beautiful voice. They don't sing like that anymore. Such a shame.
This is hell. I am in hell
right now. My husband Robert died when Will was young. He was a good writer, but I do wish he had tried a bit harder. Still, I loved him.
Grandma. Yeah, he was all right, but he could have done better. You know, not be so shit. That's the only regret I have with him.
We've family over in New Zealand. I went to visit them after James had grown up. We still write letters to each other at Christmas, you know. It's important to stay in touch with your family, even when we're so spread out.
You send them a postcard at Christmas time. It's not really keeping in touch with your family.
I like to go to the seaside at Brighton. They sell these glass animals there, handmade. I started collecting them years ago, and I still get a new one every time I visit.
Is that fucking like Magikarp? Like that one right there. By the way, oh my god, you got two of the Magikarps. Grandma, you've only been there like fucking 6 times. All right, we'll continue on.
Back then, Diana had just done that interview, and so we were all waiting for the divorce. There was no way we thought that they could stay together.
Yep, Grandma, you're always the fucking optimist.
People seem to believe that all us old folk want to talk about is the weather. So I started the conversation.
Yeah, this'll be good.
I think it's sad. She was bullied into all of this from the beginning.
No, that's all you had to say.
The conversation didn't go well from there. I got very frustrated with him.
Conflicting points of view. Grandma will slap your shit, dude.
Sharon didn't join in, but it wasn't hard to imagine what an American might think of it all.
What the fuck, Grandma? Jesus, fuck, you are such an asshole.
James didn't help. He has always been so obtuse in his views.
So, let me get this straight. Anyone that doesn't agree with your point of view is fucking wrong, or an American. Fucking Grandma.
I wish I'd never even started the conversation.
Yeah, me
they
fucking
didn't want
too.
To hear my opinion.
Am
Excuse
I
me.
Lifting.
I'm going to make some tea, I said.
Fucking
no
Jesus.
One offered to help.
What? Grandma, it's fucking tea. It's fucking tea. You don't need help making tea. You put hot water in a fucking kettle, like a kettle. And then you heat it up. And then you pour it onto a little fucking tea bag. This is not a difficult process. If you need help with this, maybe we should put you in a nursing home. Okay? Just fucking Jesus Christ. You are the fucking, like, absolute... What is wrong with this family? This family is full of hipsters and fucking pessimists. Just here, let me help you make your fucking tea.
I didn't really want tea. I don't think they wanted it either. But I needed to do something.
Wow, that was fucking hard. Good thing I cannot imagine you did this by yourself.
I know it seems like a small thing, but... Maybe it was the first time that I felt apart from Will. There wasn't any choice in my day, but it gave me a quiet life. That was good enough.
Good, okay.
These days it's easier to be different, to forge your own path or something like that, and everyone else be damned.
Yeah, that's right. Don't fucking choose individuality. Stay the same. Don't ruffle the feathers.
I wish Will understood that you've got to fit in to get along in life.
Oh my God, you make me want to stick my head in the fucking garbage disposal.
James and Sharon both held their own views. I knew that. But Will...
Holy shit, just get the tea.
About him getting all these views. It could get him into trouble. I was so scared
fucking...
that Will was going to go off half-cocked and make a mess of his life.
Listen, he just didn't agree with you on your fucking Princess Diana bullshit, okay? Seriously, he's not going to go fucking down the road. He's not going to be like, oh man, I think Princess Diana was like fucking forced into this and then start shooting up heroin. This is not how things work, Grandma. Just fucking eat your cookies.
Letting the tea brew.
Kind of like it was a fucking, like, tea thing. Tea kettle.
And I cried. He was so headstrong. And he was going to make mistakes. I knew it. I couldn't change his mind.
Jesus, I cannot wait until Grandma finds out he's gay. This is going to be a fucking catastrophe.
I knew something had been broken that day between Will and I.
Nothing was broken. It was just a conversation about Princess Diana. Holy shit. Take the tea. Get out there.
I took a deep breath and pulled myself together. It simply doesn't do to let others see you get upset.
God damn. Switch to a new person, please. For love of God, anyone. I don't care who. I don't care if I have to talk to the dog for the next, like, 30 minutes.
I live by myself. I always have.
Jesus, that's a surprise.
I had felt this was acceptable until then. Feeling distant from your family is the most awful thing. It's the strangest feeling of mourning.
Sit
I know
down,
I'm
Grandma.
From a different generation with different values, but I don't think they're all wrong.
No, Grandma, you're not wrong. You're just fucking... I'm sure even when you were younger, you were probably an asshole.
I wasn't prepared to accept that Will wasn't going to talk to me anymore. You can't accept it, really, when you see someone you love putting their future at risk.
There was nothing at risk. There's literally nothing. He's not doing anything. Fucking... Oh, God damn it. By the way, old people tend to hang plates on their fucking walls for some reason. I have no idea why. This one's gone out of their way a little bit. And honest to God, Grandma, if you don't fucking organize these plates, I will snap. And I will hit you with one of these plates. Probably one of the smaller ones. You know? Because you're older. But if you keep this shit up, it might escalate into a bigger one. Just
all
take
these
this.
Free ideas about people choosing their own way to live. He would understand later. But how much later?
Dude, I will literally... I cannot stand you. You are a fictional fucking character. And you make me want to hang myself with the tablecloth. This is crazy. You are absolutely out of your fucking mind.
But before he changed, what damage would he do to his options?
Oh no, probably do meth, Grandma, okay? Christ, he's probably fucking smoking meth and giving handjobs right this second.
I was nervous about that Christmas. We hadn't been close for a while.
I am really impressed that you just, like, took a reef. You just managed to morph it onto your table.
It's a lot of work making a house look welcoming, but it was good to be busy.
At the end of this decorating, we're gonna go and put a giant T on the, you know, a giant cross on the front yard and just light it on fire.
I remember a Christmas after Will had gone to university, but we were all coming back together for the holiday. I try to keep in touch with friends. Of course, there was no email or that sort of thing back then. There's nothing like a real letter now, though.
Yeah, waiting, like 20 minutes. 20 minutes, holy shit, I'm having an aneurysm right now. Just put another one on there. Grandma, how fucking old are you? If you turn out to be like 55, I'm gonna be like really shocked. Alright, just fucking do this one next. Come on. It's right there. Grandma, get down there. Come on.
I wanted right, the just, house to look perfect. Will was going to bring a girlfriend, Sarah, and I wanted her to get the right impression.
Oh, shit. This is going to be the worst, isn't it? There we go. We'll just start plopping people in place. This is when Grandma finds out she's Jewish and he fucking, like, she flips her shit.
My family arrived just as the Christmas lunch was ready. It was perfect timing. It was lovely meeting Sarah. She was a little shy, I think. She said a little about what she was studying and how happy she was with it all. She made a very good impression. James is like my husband Robert. Kind at heart, but I wish he would apply himself.
Holy shit, there is literally not one time you've clicked where it hasn't been like some backhanded comment.
Did I tell you that Sharon and James split up for 3 years once? Will spent the time in America with her family. It was hard for me not seeing him. He was 10 and, like most boys, he wasn't interested in writing many letters.
No one's interested in writing letters. Like, I fucking hate writing letters. Like, I love my family and stuff, but God damn it, if I had to write a letter to, like, my mom every week, I'd probably end up late. I just couldn't do it. I'd have to send an email.
I was very worried about seeing Will. No, I wanted him to understand that when we disagreed, I didn't mean anything against him personally. I just wanted to keep him safe.
Yeah. I just want you to know, Will, that even though you were, you know, completely, absolutely, and utterly wrong, that I don't have anything against you, per se. It's just everything you stand for.
Will was a perfect gentleman.
Okay. Come on. Will, what? How the fuck are you cutting that like that?
He was so courteous and attentive.
Oh, just fucking, you click on it and it just goes away. Just, here we go. Fuck me, there's so much stuff here. Alright, just, goddamn, dude, I know this is a Christmas dinner, but shit.
I felt so proud of Will. He was becoming the man I had hoped he would be. Sarah seemed like such a lovely match for him. He would have a happy, normal life. But that was the last time I saw her.
Wow, what a tragedy. You can get up now. Is there anything else for me to click? He's just... Oh. Alright, cool. You keep looking to the left there. I cannot take much more of Grandma. Jesus, Grandma.
The next
Can't
summer,
you do, like,
I went
that
to visit
free
Will
game?
At university.
Just do like the free game does, where you sit down on a park bench and then you just, like, die. And then that's the end of the game. Can we do that one?
Arriving on time is a common courtesy, so often overlooked, I feel. So I set off in plenty of time to drive down to see him. Right. I arrived early and decided to have a look at the campus. It was my first time there, and the buildings looked lovely.
How amazing.
So many excited young people about the place, and such beautiful girls, all full of pep. I was also hoping I might see Sarah again.
Dude, let Sarah go. You met
University
her for like an hour.
University wasn't a normal option for people in my time, and I never went. A solid education helps to improve a person.
That's amazing,
I noticed
Grandma.
Will from a distance. I've always thought he stood out in a crowd. At first, I couldn't see what he was doing. Then I saw that he was holding hands with a man.
Holy shit, what a scandal. This'll be interesting.
And then, right out in front of everyone, they kissed.
Holy shit, how horrifying. Grandma, are you gonna fucking lose your mind? Please lose your mind.
He went and did that after everything I had tried to teach him. I knew that all those liberal views would get him in trouble.
Yeah. Apparently if you're fucking, like, I don't know. Jesus Christ. See, this is what happens. This is what you get for, like, sticking up for Princess Diana. Soon, you're, like, having a good time. You're, like, you know, hey, this might not be a, you know, bad thing. And then, boom. The door opens and suddenly you're gay. And then Grandma disowns you.
I left
Christ,
right
this game
away.
Is fucking weird. Grandma, fucking calm your fucking tits.
What was I supposed to say to him then?
Hi. That's usually what would happen.
Will hadn't seen me. I simply had no idea how I could be expected to act like everything would be okay for him.
He's just gay, dude. Like, relax.
He was so young to be doing that kind of thing, with his whole life ahead.
Oh my God, Grandma. Just have an aneurysm. Stroke
Suddenly,
out right here.
University seemed ugly, obscene. All that sense of entitlement, but no appreciation.
Yeah, okay. There
My generation worked so hard trying to raise up our country. And this was what happened to the grandchildren. It was all a waste.
You know, I am very calm. Like, I am super, like, my viewpoints are pretty goddamn neutral. But holy shit, do I want to punch Grandma right in the fucking throat.
After everything I had done for him, he was doing that. Putting himself in danger. I felt so angry with him and with everyone there.
The fuck, dude? He's not like he's, like, banging a gang member. Like, seriously.
That sort of thing. It all just feels wrong to me. Sorry, but that's just the way I feel about this.
Well, you feel like you're fucking retarded, so that's fine. Oh, God. Just get to the fucking point here. This is coming off a little fucking, like, contrived and forced. Like, it's cool. I understand.
I barely saw Will for the next few years. I couldn't bring myself to talk to him.
Listen. Alright. I have no idea. Like, if I ever had a son, he turned out to be gay, I'd be like, that's fine, dude. I don't care. I don't fucking give a shit where you put your penis. It's not my fucking problem. I don't care. But Grandma, you gotta let it go. You're destroying this family right now.
I suppose it was silly of me.
Yes, it was. This is fucking... Are you going into the shed? Like, what is in the shed? Please. That'd be like some kind of weird BDSM, like, tortured, like, shed.
After university, he went traveling, seeing the world. I stayed at my house.
Okay. This game is, like, just fucking shoehorning this. Like, we got it. Grandma doesn't like gay liberals, okay? And she doesn't rightly mind, like, the gay Republicans, but the liberals, oh, not on her watch.
Being alone in a house by yourself. I said my husband Robert died when Will was young, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Being alone can make you live in the past. You watch the world change without you.
You don't say. Just take a seat, Grandma. Holy shit, if Will kills himself because of, like, Grandma, fucking man up, dude. It's Grandma. Grandma's fucking nuts, okay? Grandma's probably on the way to getting Alzheimer's. Holy shit, okay.
I don't know if he knew how much I loved him when he was growing up. He's still that tiny, playful little boy in my head, I think. I had such hopes for Will, and all the things that he would be when he was a man.
Then he dashed them away. I am serious, this is so repetitive right now. Like, I fucking get it, Grandma. Let's move on to a different character archetype.
Goes on.
Not much longer for you.
I was
Come
working
on.
In the garden. Things go wild if you leave them too long.
Holy shit, please, Grandma. Don't do this. Of course, you live right literally next to some crazy church, probably. Just pick the weeds there. Whatever the fuck those things are.
Will would occasionally send me a postcard from somewhere foreign on his travels.
Come on. This is pretty ridiculous right now.
I was still angry at him, but I worried too. He was just off somewhere, before the travel writing became his job.
Okay, so he was a writer Fucking cool. Oh, God. By the way, Grandma, is this like your lynching tree? It wouldn't surprise me if you had one. Jesus, Grandma, just fucking relax. You don't have to go that crazy on the weeds, alright? Oh, hey, look at that. You got a fucking person coming to visit you. Come on, get up. We gotta move. It's a, you know, nothing like the present. Just get in here. Where is the front? Alright. You do that. Oh my God, there's so much clicking.
I was going to answer it, but snagged my foot in the grass and twisted my ankle.
How? It's fucking like 2 inches.
It hurt like blazes, and I lay there feeling like a complete fool.
That's because no one in the history of humanity has ever tripped on 2-inch grass.
There was no way I was going to be able to stand. But the doorbell had gone again. I called out for help.
Yeah, you know, I'm not feeling too bad for you, Grandma.
I heard footsteps around the side of the house.
All right, come on. Who is that? It's gonna be Will, isn't it?
It was Will.
Fucking knew it.
Coming to visit me. He'd come back from traveling.
All right.
After all I had done. After all I hadn't done. He was the one reaching out to me. He was the one who made the effort.
Yeah, crazy.
He looked after me anyway.
Holy shit, Will! Okay, listen. I've picked up people all the fucking time, as part of my job. That is a really hard position to get someone into.
I saw especially inside Grandma. The man he was, the same kind boy that I knew.
Grandma, you've got to weigh at least 220. You are heavy.
I don't claim that I'll understand some of his choices.
Oh, Jesus God, fucking let it go for 5 minutes. Let's get you inside.
But inside, he really always had been the man that I wanted him to be. Kind and strong. I'd missed that, blinded by only one part of him. He was still everything I could have hoped for. He was even kind to a fool like me.
Holy shit. Okay, we get it.
I'll never forget that.
Let's just fucking shoehorn some more tropes in here. Come on now. You know, I understand he's trying to tell a really touching story, but I'm just not getting it. It is way too force-fed. Alright, put the
Grandma
fucking coffee cup down.
Grandma grew up in different times. She loves me. And she understands that I love Harry. I get that that makes her uncomfortable still, but she is trying. I should go see her this weekend.
Yeah, go for it. Alright, just open this thing up. What did you get? What was the point of... Oh. Cereals. Clever. Eat your fucking cereal now. Right there. Oh, you need to get milk. I forgot. People eat cereal with milk. I never understood that. I like my cereal dry. Like, it just makes my fucking, like, cereal soggy. It's fucking gross. They just eat that bad boy up. Oh, I do like a glass of milk with my cereal. Where are you going? The fucking table's right there.
She kept on telling me what a real man should be like. That's not me. But I think I'm okay. I'm the man I grew up to be. And now I'm thinking about marrying Harry.
Okay, cool. Sit down on the couch and eat your fucking cereal. What are you reading? If it's the night before Christmas, I will fucking call you out on it. I have no idea what that says. Will Wright, for shoes. Oh, Will Wright for shoes.
But Harry just wants this normal life. These patterns.
Wow, how fucking cruel and believable. Like, dude, it's a normal life. Come on. Everyone's so fucking cynical in here. Jesus, you mope so much, Will. Oh my god. Just drag your feet into the kitchen. I can't believe it. My grandmother fucking hates me because I'm gay. And then all of a sudden, my boyfriend, who I want to get married to, doesn't want to have, crazy, super awesome adventures all the time. Goddamn, dude.
He built this life for us. I went off and traveled, and he made all this happen.
Wow. So you're fucking literally mooching off him. Is that what you're saying? And then you have the balls to bitch about it. Dude, at this point, I'm just jumping down everyone's ass. Like, this game is, I don't like any of the characters right now. I kind of liked you. Fucking the only one that I still like, maybe, is Harry, and Harry's fucking sleeping. Do you have any idea how much it takes for someone to hate someone that sleeps? It takes a lot. So it's not saying much that Harry's the only one I don't mind.
Time to get ready.
Get in the fucking bathroom. Get changed, shave, whatever. Let's go about our day. Let's see. Okay, just go in there.
Love isn't unique. It's common.
That is poorly rendered ass. I was in love with Sarah
once. That changed in the end.
Your posture is fucking weird.
What would be the point in marriage? I hurt Sarah when I was with her. I'll hurt Harry too, in the end. I don't deserve someone like him.
Oh, okay. Not even gonna make a fucking joke about that. Let's just go. Self-wallowing. Holy shit, why is everything in color now?
My first day at university. My parents drove me in a car stuffed full of everything I owned. I'd been a bit nervous all day, but I felt full-on terrified when we got to the student village.
What the fuck is in your... Oh, it's a chair turned upside down.
I tried to look confident. It was faked. I'm not sure anyone noticed either way.
Why are you... You're at a uni... You are literally the most fucking hipster girl ever. You're perfect for him. Well, besides the fact of having a vagina, but you're perfect because you're wearing a black shirt with your little fucking sweater tied around your hips, and then you're wearing combat boots and camo fucking fatigue short pant things. I don't know.
Paul, my mom's boyfriend, always liked Will.
Yeah, they always do. Come on.
Looking at all my things in the boot of the car, I never knew I had so much stuff.
Excuse me, what the fuck is the boot? Do you mean the trunk? Alright, I'm gonna just go upstairs now. Come on. There we go.
I think Mum or Paul must have picked up the keys from somewhere. Weird that I don't remember how we got them now. I went up first.
There we go. Opening the door. Dude, this is super cool. The fact that you have, that door, and then this door, and then your door. That's three doors you have to go through for someone to, murder you. That is awesome.
Walking into my dorm room for the first time, I could only think about my own nerves.
Holy shit, your dorm is huge. It's one of those things that
we
do sometimes.
We forget about the feelings of others. Yes, I was scared about it all, but how did Mum and Paul feel? After unloading the car, they were about to drive away to an empty home for the first time in 18 years. Maybe it was a scarier day for them than for me.
No, I'm pretty sure they're totally fine with it. You'll always be their daughter. But for fuck's sake, dude. They want you out of the house so they can have crazy weird sex again. Close. Okay, we're going back outside. Howdy doody, Dad. What's going on? He's just gonna carry all my boxes? That's nice. I hate clicking this, over and over again, only to move, 6 feet. Just, god damn it, just pick up the boxes.
I was unloading in a dream. I had a room that was all my own. It seemed unreal. Cheap carpet and a thin mattress. It didn't matter. It was my space. It had four walls and a door that I could lock. I was frightened, sure, but also excited. I had my own key and all the stuff that goes with that.
Wait, did you not have your own room when you lived with your parents? That is unusual, especially for being 18. Having oh my god, we're gonna have to go back.
Being 18? Yes, of course I was thinking about dating. I guess everyone
what?
Was.
Okay. Sure, I guess.
I suppose we all felt ugly in some way.
I don't.
It's a strong word, but I thought everyone was beautiful except me.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty good looking. I'm very beautiful. So, I mean, if you're talking about me, sure, yeah. Why not? Keep going. You've got things to unpack. Fucking you and your combat fatigues.
It wasn't like the heavens opened and shone down a ray of sunlight onto his face when I first saw him. He looked really cute, though. Sexy, I think.
Actually, that tweed jacket dude was sexy.
The right word. I didn't really think about sexy back then, I guess.
You're fucking 18. How are you not thinking about that? Wait, what? Is he? Oh, hey, look, he's down here. Let me just go back down here. Okay. Wow, are you driving a Cadillac?
It's funny to think back like this.
Dude,
now.
Will's got a shaggin' wagon. That's fucking amazing. Alright, hi. We got things to do now. Just load a little faster. Just come on. Did the game freeze on me? No, okay, fucking wow. That took forever.
I didn't notice Will again for a couple of weeks. If I'm honest, I'd forgotten about him while I got set up in my new home. Though he must have been in the lectures. So anyway, I next noticed him through the window of the Union Bar.
Wait. What do you mean, Union Bar? The University of Winchester. Wait, is there a fucking bar on campus?
I recognized
what kind
him
of fucking weird shit
day?
Is this?
And I remembered liking how he'd look back at me then.
With his pale, featureless face. Amazing. Just come on, let's go down there. Oh my god. This is seriously the most pretentious college ever.
The music scene was good back then. Blur, Pulp, Elastica, Thingy, Suede. All those bands were great.
Huh?
Not that the Union played them much. It was more dancey in there.
I really like EDM, and I have no fucking idea. What you said, seriously, that's a fucking issue. You're just making shit up now.
As much as it was tacky in there, I miss it too. It was crowded, hard to talk, and the floor was sticky from spilled Alcopops, but it was fun.
Alcopops? What in God's fucking name is an Alcopop? I'm gonna sing right here. Alright, let's do this. Get out of the fucking way. I've got things to do.
After I'd seen him at the window, I wanted to talk to him. Maybe more.
Excuse me.
I pretty much went on the hunt.
What are you talking about, the hunt?
Finding Will wasn't
bang,
easy.
I'm just,
I definitely wasn't the tallest person there, and the lights didn't help.
Not even that dark. We're literally phasing people out of our way.
I felt like a new woman already. Or I was on my way, at least.
Holy shit. Alright, so now you're coming of age.
Will
that's
always
amazing.
Gave me a good vibe.
God, just get out of my fucking way!
There it is. He just felt like a good person. He was, too.
Yeah, okay. You know, people say that about fucking serial killers, too, right? Where is he? Where did you go? How do I get over there? What is going on? Excuse me, I need to... Okay. I'm supposed to fucking buy a drink. Yeah, the fucking... You never get a beer that fast. Well, maybe if you're a woman. Maybe, I don't know. Come on, just get the fucking drink, let's go! Got things to do. Suddenly easier.
I joined in whatever the conversation was that Will was having. I've no idea what we talked about.
I was gonna go behind the bar and start serving, but barely not.
I think I was pretty obvious in my intentions.
Dude, you've got tons of freckles. Like, a lot of freckles. Seriously? You're holding hands.
We had a few drinks and tried to talk over the music before I pulled him outside.
Oh, God. All right. Just fucking... Come on, I am clicking so hard right now. Just keep it up. Come on.
You know the feeling?
There we go.
The rush of anticipation?
Yeah.
I was getting that so much.
Yeah, you sound like it. You sound like you're fucking going crazy right now. Why is it louder there? Jesus, God help me. Holy shit, I'm flying.
It was cold, but in a welcome way. We went to sit for a moment, to look at the view.
Of course. Yeah, hell of a fucking view. Oh my God, is it this one? Please just sit down. I'm tired of walking with you fuckers. Oh, you sit on the grass. Romantic. I'm gonna sit right next to you. I'm gonna sit, like, right here. Aw. You cute little lovebirds. Oh, that's cool.
And that was when he first kissed me.
Could you not do a kiss scene there? Probably because they don't have moving lips. Screen to Winchester. This looks like something out of fucking Portal.
We went to the cinema for our first proper date.
This is a fucking movie theater? Oh, alright. Oh, you know, fuck that. We're going straight to the front. You fucking go big or you go home.
I remember we sat at the front.
You goddamn right we did.
I felt self-conscious with all the people behind us.
Fuck your self-consciousness. We're watching this movie like a pro. Wow. That compression. Wow, you can do a cartwheel. What? What the fuck was that?
We both fidgeted.
All right.
To work out how to start.
Hold hands. That's a good thing. Hold hands or put your arm around him. Not you. The dude, well, you gotta put your arm around her.
I kept on trying to look at him from the side to see if he was looking at me.
Dude, he is too busy checking out these sick moves right now.
I wanted to hold his hand, but he seemed to shy away. Or maybe he didn't intend that.
I don't know, maybe.
I shifted in my seat a bit, letting my leg touch his. I was so smooth.
Yeah. Oh, we're just gonna look
at the film.
Had
that guy in it who always acts crazy but then does lots of action kick-ass stuff.
No, this was not kick-ass stuff. I was seriously not paying. No, this is not kick-ass stuff. This is weird.
It was like everything else faded out.
God, I wish it would. Oh, literally, it's gonna fade out. Hold
his
hand,
I plucked up the courage and put my hand on his leg, and he gave me one of his lovely, shy smiles.
Yeah, that was a hell of a smile. That weird... Oh, God, no.
He reached out and gently brushed my cheek with his hand, guiding my face to his.
Okay, this is gonna be awkward.
He closed his eyes and kissed me.
Beautiful.
Placing his lips softly onto mine.
Then went back to watching the kick-ass stuff.
We sat with our fingers locked together for the rest of the film. And when it was over, we walked out, still holding hands. Did you ever fall in love so hard and so much you just knew it would have to end? It was my first time, But even back then, I think I knew deep down that's what it was.
You know, you're 18. You're still a little baby.
Will always gave the impression of confidence, like he always had a grand plan. I wish I knew if he saw that end coming too, like I felt it was. I don't know if that would have made how it went any easier.
Well, you can't blame him. He's fucking gay. He's young, dude. He's 18, for God's sakes, dude. Jesus, here, let's fucking...
I'd been putting off...
You were still wearing the same shit.
But the next day, I finally got round to it. I got out the essentials, of course, but I hadn't felt very motivated to do the rest.
Yeah, apparently the essentials is your beanie there. Oh, what is all this stuff? Oh,
when
I thought it was
born,
a cat.
When I was born, someone from my mum's work gave me a toy bunny. I know it's silly, but it makes me happy.
Dude, if it makes you happy, do it to it.
It wasn't always easy with my biological dad leaving, but Mum and I, and my brother Andy, we had fun. My bunny makes me remember that.
That's cool. That's actually kind of a cool bunny.
My mum gave me a tasseled cloth scarf to remind me of home. She's a right hippie.
Really? And you're not. Okay, so there's that.
There were some candles my mum had given me. Will was coming over later that week, and I was falling for him, so I thought I'd make it more cozy in there. Is it weird to tell you this?
No, I guess. I don't know. These are candle stick holders.
I'd packed loads of my old books. Nothing really related to uni. I just liked having them nearby.
Excuse me.
I kept on changing my mind.
You've got to be kidding me. Please don't make me do this. Please don't make me do this.
It shouldn't have mattered so much, but I wanted the place to look nice.
Here, I'm going to put this fucking bunny.
I must have spent ages just shifting stuff around.
Please don't make me put ages everywhere. Let me end this. Oh my god.
The little choices are important.
Yeah, I guess so. Okay, we'll put them
right there.
I guess
it didn't make any difference, really. But I was happy when I was sure I'd got it right. I wanted to feel comfortable when Will came over.
You know, guys, really, unless your room is super fucked up, guys probably don't really care.
Will and I, it felt like a Romeo and Juliet kind of thing. And just as likely to burn us both as to make us happy.
Yeah, you know Romeo and Juliet both, like, died.
But what a
it's
lovely way to burn.
Not a good relation. Oh. The fact that you have your shoes on in bed, like, upsets me. I cannot believe how long this game is. Yeah, okay.
That
you know
Christmas,
what? Back
I
at grandma.
Will's family.
Motherfucker.
For 4 months. Do you remember me there?
Yes, I do. I truly do. You're the only other person besides grandma and Will to have a face.
I was so worried I was going to say something and embarrass myself. I was much more shy back then, and I was really in love with Will, and I wanted to make sure I didn't mess anything up. I kept on wanting to touch him. There was this really good chemistry with him, but with family around, it didn't seem right.
Yeah, probably shouldn't do that around mom, dad, and crazy racist grandma.
I got nice shivers when he touched me as he poured my wine. It was a really nice meal, and we all got on okay.
I feel like I could be reading this. I don't have to experience this again. Like, this, I really don't have to fucking experience this again. All right, just come on, just do the stuff here.
You only get to make one first impression, so I probably should have worn something else. I felt quite self-conscious.
Are you still wearing those same fucking pants?
I loved him so much.
God damn it.
But that feeling I had wouldn't go away, that it was all going to end. That Christmas day, though, I felt like we had a chance.
Great. Okay. You can move forward. Wow, the same hints over and over again.
Things were going well, but over the months, I felt the relationship changing.
Do you guys just not move for weeks at a time?
We would listen to music as we fell asleep. Will had a CD recording of a thunderstorm. The sound of the rain was relaxing, but there were a couple of bits of thunder that would make me jump.
Fucking how loud were you listening to it? It doesn't have to be on, like, fucking max blaring crazy... you know what? Fuck it. You can't even handle this. You can't even handle the club right now.
Even now, when I listen to them, I remember being back in that room, in his arms. I could feel the end of it all shaping up. But we had good times anyway. Though sometimes lonely, in a weird way.
Hell, you guys haven't even fucking moved in weeks.
Feeling like the only people in the world. You cherish the other person, but you long for another life too. Maybe I didn't mind Will getting closer to Harry because it felt like our own love was too much for two people.
I'm sorry. What the fuck does that mean right now?
We were all, Will, Harry, and me, studying on the same English degree. I'd seen the way Harry and Will looked at each other. There was a spark there. I didn't feel jealous. I know that sounds weird, but I liked seeing Will happy, and Harry made him feel that way. I'll never forget that time. Seeing their friendship grow. We would cuddle up in bed and watch TV or movies. Coronation Street had a transgender character. It wasn't something I'd thought much about before.
Okay, what? Alright.
Being straight, I'd never thought much about my sexuality. I never felt that I needed to. I was me. Will was just himself too. And I just kind of accepted that.
Well, duh. I mean, sexuality isn't... It shouldn't be your defining fucking feature. Like, no matter what you are. It's just part of who you are in the grand scheme of things. Fucking seriously, dude.
It's funny to tell you this now, but I was never jealous of Harry. You'd think I would be, but I loved Will so much. I just wanted him to be happy. As the months went by, we went out less. We would go out to meet up with Harry and a couple of other friends, but it was mostly just Will and me. Those memories will always be a warm place for me.
That's amazing. Good for you.
It might seem odd to you, but it was my suggestion.
Okay.
I told Will to ask out Harry. I loved
him. That is, yeah.
I knew it would make us all happy for Will to have Harry in his life.
That is a really weird thing to actually suggest. Like, seriously, that's not something a normal person would fucking do.
I feel lucky. How many times in your life will you be sure you've helped a person find their true love?
Oh my god, this is so fucking pretentious.
For a long time, I wished that true love had been me.
Jesus, God help me. None of this would fucking happen in the real world. Okay? Like, you don't feel that way. Oh, this is too goddamn fairy-tailed up. Like, you got the evil grandma. You know, she just doesn't understand the kids. And then the fucking girlfriend is super understanding.
Of the end. Will had been seeing both me and Harry at the same time for about 6 months.
Why? Why would you let that go on?
It's weird, but it really wasn't.
No, it was very weird.
We were all open, safe, and honest about it. The picture... It was October, and we met in the basement of the Royal
Oh my god, look at all this shit
Smoking
I have to click.
Smoking was still allowed in pubs, and a faint smell clung to everything.
There, click it. Click
it. The chairs were covered with a tapestry weaving type of fabric that was worn away from years of use.
Okay, put the pictures on the wall. He's not going to say anything about the painting.
It was that old, heavy pub furniture. There was the muffled sound of the George Street traffic.
Jesus Christ, I don't need to click on it after this shit.
I had a friend before uni who was having boyfriend problems and asked me what love is.
Oh my God, do not answer. You have no idea right now. You're fucking 18. When you are 18, chances are you don't know what real love is. Like,
I told
fucking
her that
seriously.
Love was being able to tell a person that you never wanted
to
see.
Oh my God. You make me want to hang myself. This game is physically making me ill with
Even
all the tropes.
Even though it broke your heart to do it, you would tell them to leave you.
I want to run headfirst as hard as I can into the wall. This is so many fucking tropes that it's ridiculous. Just click on all this shit here. I'm right there. Let me just click this shit out of this. Come on. Please. Oh,
God damn
it. I
was quite happy with that answer. Like love was something from a Shakespearean tragedy.
Oh, God. This is so... I'm gonna vomit.
I hadn't been in love when I said it.
Yeah. Just click on this shit.
I didn't expect to have to do it.
But I don't understand what you mean.
I didn't expect to be right.
Oh, fucking here. This is literally the second fucking choice.
We need to talk.
Oh?
This needs to change. I'm not helping you anymore. Okay, we'll do this.
This needs to change.
You mean us?
I feel like I'm getting in your way.
You're not. This is good.
This is weird. Like, not just fucking everything, like, about the whole super weird, like, Shakespearean, like, mostly her. Everything about her is kind of weird. Yeah, all right. She's kind of weird, though. Just, I don't know. It's like she's living in a play. You too, actually. Fucking all you people are weird.
Sure, but I don't know if it's good for you.
I'd like to be the one making that choice.
I'm happy with you. I love you, but this isn't about me.
I love you too. I want to be with you.
I know, but I don't think you should be.
Is this it? Can I do anything differently?
Yeah, okay. No, you've done nothing wrong. I'll click this
no,
one, I guess.
You've not done anything wrong.
I don't want this.
Me either. But it's right.
I love you.
I love you too.
Fuck, let's get out of here!
I'm so in love. I can't tell you how much it hurt to let him go.
It probably hurt a whole lot.
I never forgot him. Love doesn't just stop when you split up. It barely even fades, really. It just mellows with age and memory. I've never loved anyone like that again.
Oh, God, you're what, 20 now? I can't believe that. This is so overdramatic. This is like one of those games that's... It's too much. He's trying to convey a story, but it's fucking ham-fisting it down my throat.
It took me 2 years to get over Will. I saw him falling deeper and deeper in love with Harry. Maybe we all could have kept on dating together the way we were. I didn't think of that as an option at the time.
Generally because it's not.
I threw myself into my studies to try to forget. I graduated with first-class honors, so I guess it worked out well. I never really forgot that feeling of love for Will, but eventually I dated again and fell in love again.
Wait, your degree was only 2 years?
I don't feel the same love, though. Two loves are never the same. This new one is wonderful, too, and different. That's a good thing.
Oh, my God. Here we go. We're still reminiscing about him.
The way I loved Will and he loved me was something special. Not forever, but perfect anyway.
Fuck, I'll go get the phone. Stay right there. Alright, you just go do your weird walk thing. Oh, thank God you've changed your pants. Oh my God, we're still in the fucking shower. I didn't stop loving
Sarah. I haven't stopped. Though it's different now. We still meet and catch up. There was a reason we dated. She's wonderful. We both moved on okay. In the end.
Okay, amazing. Grab your fucking towel.
But right.
Who cries with a towel like that? Who?
It's something amazing. She saw that coming. She's smart.
Oh, God. Did you just put your dirty clothes back on? You disgust me as a human being. Dude, if your grandma fucking knew about that, she would lose her goddamn mind. All right, brush your teeth,
dude. The small things mean a lot. Sarah set me in motion to be here now. A word, an act. Just going through everyday life with someone. It all has meaning.
Yeah, I'm sure it does. Okay, you know what? Wow, dude, you are going batshit crazy with that mouth cologne. You need, like, two spritzes. That's it. It's like, whoosh. Cologne is supposed to be for intimate, like,
marriage on
times.
My mind.
That's it.
Scent of sandalwood in my armpits. Sexy.
Alright, you know what? Fuck you, because sandalwood is pretty awesome. It's like my little fucking aftershave. But seriously, everything else, you're fucking weird. This is some heavy rain shit right now. Wait, do you have a ducky? You're a grown ass man and you have a ducky in your bathtub. Yeah, just moose up your fucking hair. Let's go, dude. God damn, dude. Everything is like a million fucking clicks to get from point A to point fucking B. Alright? Just let me click once. Let me click one goddamn time and just go through all this shit.
I've lost some of the wide-angle view of my life.
I want
our lives to work. Harry and I.
Oh, Will, I'm gonna tear your fucking eyes out of your skull. That's beautiful animation.
We have love. I don't doubt that. Love is wonderful as it is. And I guess there's even bigger adventures than marriage.
Sure, yeah.
We could start a family. Kids. Wow. That could be good, actually. Maybe I'll leave that conversation to another day, eh? One thing at a time.
Dude, you were just talking literally about how you were just saying, like, how fucking boring it's gonna be with, like, to live with this guy for the rest of your life. And then you want kids. Like, you need to make up your goddamn mind.
What if I propose to him and he says no?
I don't know, dude. How about you just ask? Like, you don't generally pop it out of the blue. I mean, no. Generally know when the right time is when they're gonna say yeah.
He wants this too, right?
Well, he's living with you, so I assume so. Or you're living with him. Which is kind of weird. What was that? Oh, hey, look at this. Love you. There we go. Me too. See you die. There we go. Cool. That's probably for the good ending. Just come on. I'm clicking on you now. Hey, just no. There we go. Go say goodbye.
I think Harry wants a family. We'll talk about it. I think it would be good.
I'm sure it would be. If you didn't act like a fucking weirdo half the time. So come on, let's get to it. Let's look in the mirror one last fucking time.
This is gonna be a big day.
Oh shit. Why is it gonna be a big day? What is going on here? I missed something because I wasn't paying attention to this fucking story. Did you really just brush your shoulder off? Get in the fucking car. Why do we keep walking back and forth? We walk from there, to there, to there, to there, to there, to there. Just fucking dude, your pattern. I'm starting to understand it, why you're so fucking upset with it. It's horrible.
First step change up your pattern. Journey. It's going to be wonderful.
I'm sure it is. Or you'll be hit by a car. Oh, there we go. Fucking there.
I love you. Have a good day. This life's
dude,
been kind
still
to
sleeping.
Me. And I've got to change. To stop taking it for granted.
That's the weirdest fucking door closing animation ever. Alright, just there we go.
I forget sometimes how beautiful
again.
This city is.
Please don't make me do the driving scene over again. That was like a minute and a half of nothingness. And in the grand scheme of things, I know that means absolutely fucking nothing. But I don't want to do it over again. Oh my god, we're gonna do this again.
Sure,
come on.
I go to the gym. But will that see me through?
I don't know, Will.
Little bits of exercise are better than an occasional hour.
Come on,
keep going. I
should feel
closer to Harry, but the tech is like a tide slowly pulling at us.
I know,
no more.
I've been through
I'll
this.
Stop that drift.
Yes, I understand that. We've been doing this for a while. Come on. Get down there. Oh, God. Just click the
I'm
fucking
going
thing
to change
there.
Things.
Yeah, I know you're going to change things. Fucking congratulations, dude. Let's get your wedding band or whatever. Let's get in there. There's very few games that kind of like push me to this level of like, I don't know,
I don't
like
lose
pretentious
what we've got
bullshit,
to by not attention to
calling
it.
Out on it, but it's definitely fucking there. Like, really badly. Just fucking go, dude. Come
Some
on.
Routine is good, sure.
Ugh, there's so much routine, you have no idea right
Other
now.
Other routines are just how we fill our days.
No shit, Sherlock. It's called being human. Everyone's got a routine. Every fucking thing's got a routine. Go. You know, I'm kind of glad you're gonna get hit by a car. You and your fucking motorcycle jacket. While you drive a fucking Prius. You're that kind of asshole. Alright, that's a Comcast van. See ya, Comcast van. You keep doing your thing. You're only probably like 8 hours late. Dude, what time is it? It's like 5:30 in
the
morning. Holy shit.
I'm not locked on to avoiding everything that matters.
Alright, you're good. Never mind. Don't listen to me.
Living carefree has been good, but it's not going anywhere.
I think you ran a stop sign now that I. Like, go through that again. Hey,
it's
dude, help me.
It's time to take control.
Take control of your life. Congratulations. We're gonna go buy that fucking thing.
I can't think how often we chatted there, talking late into the night.
Yep, crazy. Super duper crazy. Just keep going. Yeah, just... I don't have anything to say. Like, I've done this before. It is pretty ridiculous.
Maybe we'll go feed the ducks this weekend. I love the way they walk.
Yeah, I know. You said that before. But I want to get the good ending, if there is a multiple choice ending. Hey. I still don't understand how this fucking car accident happens. Like, where did it come from? Was it my fault? Was it his fault? Whose fault was it?
He's got to know how I feel about him. I love him so much.
Dude, wait, what? Okay, so someone runs into the back of me. I gotcha.
We loved to feed the ducks on a Sunday. We worked all through the week, and Saturdays we were too tired to do much. But Sundays were our time.
God. Alright. Yeah, let's go look at this pretentious art piece.